of Herbert and the Watermelon of Doom.
Hello, everyone.
Good evening, Lucy.
Why are you all standing in line like that?
No reason.
You're acting very strange.
No, we're not.
Yes, you are. Tell me, Boris, or I'll tickle you.
Oh, no!
All right, I'll tell you. We've got a surprise for you.
Oh, don't bother, Boris. It's a boring game anyway.
It's Victor the Crocodile.
Good evening, Lucy. I wanted to surprise you with a story. But I should have realized that none of this lot could keep a secret. Unlike my friend Herbert the Warthog. Now, he could really keep a secret. Would you like to hear my dramatic story? It's called Herbert and the Watermelon of Doom.
Gosh, yes, please.
Every day, the animals in Africa get together for some fun. One day, I decided to join them at a waterhole. Hey, guys, this is fun, hey? What? What have I done now?
Your tail splashing, and that's not allowed.
I was only having fun.
And you were snapping your jaws.
No, I wasn't.
Yes, you were.
All right, then. I was.
That's mean.
And nasty.
But crocodiles are supposed to be mean and nasty.
Well, perhaps it would be better if just for today you could go somewhere else to do your mean and nasty splashing.
I'll show them. Mean and nasty is more fun anyway. So, I planned my revenge.
Watermelon.
Psst, Herbert. Over here.
Oh, hi, Victor.
Nice watermelon you've got there, Herbert.
Oh, thanks, Victor. Did I ever tell you about my favourite watermelon?
Frequently. But I'd love to hear it all over again.
It was 7 years ago during the rainy season. I was climbing the eastern slope of the Blue Mountain and there I saw it. It was perfectly round with yellow zigzag lines. Inside it was squidgy and juicy and... Oh!
If you'll be my friend, I'll give you this watermelon seed. It's a very special seed.
It is?
Yes, Herbert. The watermelon that grows from this seed will be the biggest, sweetest, juiciest watermelon ever.
It will?
Why don't you plant it up on Table Mountain? It'll grow faster up there. Don't tell the others. That way you don't have to share any of it. Just a little secret between us, eh?
Thanks, Victor.
Herbert buried the watermelon seed on top of Table Mountain. It sprouted right away.
Oh, yes!
Soon the watermelon was as big as a baby hippo. Herbert decided to keep it our little secret. Every day, Herbert slipped past his friends to watch his secret watermelon grow and grow.
Where's Herbert?
I don't know. Come to think of it, I haven't seen him for ages.
There he is. Where are you going, Herbert?
Oh, nowhere special.
Oh, can I come?
No. You finish your drink, Natalie.
Very strange.
Good morning, watermelon!
Oh. Herbert's watermelon had grown as big as a rhino.
Uh-oh. Victor, the watermelon. It's really big. It's getting dangerous. It could roll down from Table Mountain and land in the water hole.
Exactly.
But then we'd have no water.
Serves all your cutesy animals right for not playing with me.
But that's mean and nasty.
Exactly.
Hey, Herbert!
Not now, Zed.
I wonder what he's doing.
Herbert tried to support the watermelon so it wouldn't roll down Table Mountain.
Oh!
Herbert decided to... What had happened? He nibbled and gnawed and champed and chewed, but it was no good. The enormous watermelon grew quicker than Herbert could eat. The melon was now so big that it could be seen from miles away, and everyone knew about it.
Oh, Herbert.
Victor the crocodile told me not to. He said it was our little secret.
That was mean and nasty.
Exactly.
Anyone fancy a bite?
I think we may have a problem here. Let's see. The melon is here, and the water hole over here. According to my calculations, the watermelon will soon be so heavy, it will roll down the hill, flatten the baobab tree, bounce on Audrey's nest, and land in the waterhole with a great big splat. There.
My nest will be ruined.
We have nothing to drink.
And I'll lose my scratching post.
Exactly. Now I'm going to find a good place to watch it all go terribly wrong. Nelson had an idea.
Everybody ready?
Yes!
Okay, Natalie. Chew that stalk.
It always happened to me.
Oh! Stop it! you're tickling!
Exactly!
It's all that tickling. Do you like to be tickled, Victor?
No, I don't. It's time for bed. I told the story, so it's my turn to say goodnight.
Oh, Victor!
But don't expect me to say anything nice.
Don't worry, Victor. I know you like to be mean and nasty.
Exactly. Anyway, it's time for bed now.
Good night, Lucy!
Good night, everyone.
Sweet dreams.
64, 64, 64, 7. The story of Ronald's swimming lesson.
Hello, everyone.
Hi, Lucy. What's in the bag?
It's not for monkeys.
Did you bring something to eat?
Here, try.
Oh, But that's not something to eat.
Well, I think the colour really suits you, Boris.
Silly Boris, it's not for you either. It's my new swimming costume. I'm starting swimming lessons tomorrow. Look, there's more. A towel and a swimming cap. And best of all, armbands. Will you blow them up, please, Nelson?
At your service, madam.
Well, what do you think?
Very nice. Stripy. Just like Ronald's armbands.
Do you mean Ronald the Rhino?
Oh, yes. Ronald the Rhino had swimming lessons too. But why don't you tell Lucy the story, Nelson?
All right. Very well. It was the rainy season in Africa. And all the animals were bored. For weeks they had been waiting for the rain to stop. It wasn't much fun. Herbert, stop making those noises.
But I'm only pretending to be a raindrop. What else is there to do?
Herbert!
Stop bickering, you two! Look, the rain has stopped.
Oh, so it has.
Yippee! No more rain!
Look over there! A rainbow!
At the end of the rainbow, a seed will fall. From the seed, a tree will grow. In the wind, the fruit will swing.
What kind of fruit, Georgina? Is it watermelons?
No, not watermelons. Rainbow fruit.
Rainbow fruit? Never heard of it.
It's only the yummiest fruit ever. That's what my grandma used to say.
Hey, what are we waiting for?
Let's go and shake that tree!
And so the animals got ready for an expedition to the end of the rainbow. The animals marched and marched. The end of the rainbow was far away.
We must be nearly there. Oh no! The Zambam River is swollen!
It must be because of all that rain. We can't wade across.
Well, in that case, let's swim across instead.
Oh.
What's the matter, Ronald?
Come on, Ronald!
I can't.
What did he say?
Ronald says he can't swim!
Can't swim? What should we do now?
I have an idea. Look over there, Ronald.
Boulders!
Ronald the Rhino built a bridge across the Zambam River.
Nice and sturdy. That should do.
Oh, dear. I've an idea, too. I will dig a tunnel under the river for Ronald. Oops, wrong direction. Oh, dear. Oops, again. Silly me. Sorry. Oh, no.
I have a far better idea. Let's drink the river empty. Here, take a straw.
Oh, I just hope this works.
Ready, everyone? On the count of three. One, two, three.
Don't give up, Nelson! Keep going!
Go, Nelson! Go, Nelson! Go!
Oh.
Sorry.
Well, any more clever ideas?
It looks like I'll never get to the other side. I might as well go home.
Wait, Ronald! Look! Over there!
The tick-tick bird had the cleverest idea of all.
There! Nice and snug. How'd you like your swim belt?
Oh, tick-tick, you're the best. Well, here goes.
You can do it, Ronald!
I did it! I did it!
Let's go to the end of the rainbow!
To the end of the rainbow!
But what about Herbert?
Oh, don't worry about him. Warthogs always pop up in good time. Finally, the animals arrived at the end of the rainbow.
Lunch.
Told you so.
Not here, Herbert. I know a nice picnic spot near the river.
Oh, it's not fair.
The perfect picnic spot. You can choose first, Herbert.
More delicious even than watermelon.
And purple for me.
Would you like to share with Tick-Tick, Ronald? Ronald, Tick-Tick.
Look, over there.
It's Ronald's swim belt.
Oh, yes.
Keep going, Ronald. And now, Rhino Puzzle. You're doing great.
Ronald the Rhino had learned to swim without his swim belt, and he felt very, very proud.
Practice makes perfect.
I'm so excited about my first swimming lesson. Wait until they see me do the rhino paddle.
But now it's time for bed, Lucy.
Aww.
Get your swim bag.
Thank you, Boris. Good night.
Good night, Lucy.
Sweet dreams.
Of the juicy fruit tree.
Dropped it.
Dropped what?
What have you got?
It's a banana sandwich.
A banana sandwich?
Something smells good.
Isn't it rather late at night to be eating a sandwich?
I suppose so, but I was hungry, so I thought I'd have a midnight feast.
Yum, yum.
That sandwich really does smell delicious.
Oh, hi, Boris. Would you like a piece?
Oh, I couldn't. Not unless you insisted.
Some animals will do anything for a snack.
Boris has already eaten a huge dinner today, and two teas, and three suppers. haven't you, Boris?
I'm a growing bear.
All this talk of food reminds me of the story of the juicy fruit tree.
The what-y-what tree?
The juicy fruit tree. Its fruit is the biggest, knobbliest, most delicious...
Why don't you tell Lucy the whole story? And we might even take Boris's mind off banana sandwiches for a while.
Good idea! Every 7 years, the juicy fruit tree bears a juicy fruit. It's the biggest, knobbliest, most delicious fruit in the whole wide world. So when Zeb the zebra saw the juicy fruit, he couldn't wait to tell all the other animals.
Who's that?
It's Zeb the zebra. And he's in a hurry.
The juicy fruit tree. It's in flower.
Huh? What?
Is it that time already?
Are you sure? No doubt about it. I was galloping past when... I saw this big, knobbly fruit at the top of the juicy fruit tree.
What colour was it?
Bright red.
It's juicy fruit time!
I'm going to have the largest piece of juicy fruit.
Huh?
I have a long neck, you see. It's a long way to my tummy.
Nonsense. Elephants are the biggest, so they need the most to eat. Everyone knows that.
Now, hold on a minute. I saw it first, and I ran all the way back to tell you all. So, I deserve the biggest slice.
There are two of us, me and the tick-tick bird.
The tick-tick bird doesn't count. He only eats ticks.
We deserve the most because we're the ones who'll be climbing the tree to pick the juicy fruit.
Yes, fruit pickers come first.
Excuse me. A word of caution. The juicy fruit tree produces a juicy fruit every 7 years.
Yes?
But we must pick the fruit by sunset tomorrow.
Huh?
Before it drops down and turns into a green, gooey slime.
Yuck!
Take it easy, Tortoise. We'll go and pick the fruit tomorrow, nice and early.
The animals slept soundly that night, each one of them dreaming of the juicy fruit. They slept so well that by the time they woke up, the sun was already high in the sky.
We're late!
I knew this would happen.
Chill out. We've got loads of time. Well, we have. But by the time Toby gets there, it'll probably be too late.
Toby had short legs and a heavy shell to carry, but he hurried after the others as fast as he could.
This isn't going to be easy. The sun is going down. We only have a couple of hours before the juicy fruit drops down and turns to a green, gooey slime.
Yuck!
Don't worry. I can get it. Stand back.
Try, Ronald.
We'll have to think of something else.
This is a job for giggles and tickles.
Monkeys, do the rescue!
Ouch!
The juicy fruit tree was so smooth and slippery that it was impossible to climb.
Let me try.
We're running out of time!
Oops.
Never mind, Nelson. You almost did it.
we'll never get the juicy fruit off that tree.
The biggest, knobbliest, most delicious fruit in the world, and we can't reach it.
But help was on the way.
What this needs is teamwork.
Teamwork? What's that?
Working together. If we all work together, perhaps we'll be able to reach the juicy fruit.
Let's try.
Yeah, man. Teamwork. Let's go for it.
So the animals built an animal tower.
Hey, watch where you're putting your feet.
Whoops, sorry. This is fun.
Remember, we're a team. Can you reach the juicy fruit?
Not quite.
Audrey looked at the tree and looked at the fruit and realised there was only one thing for it. She was the tallest, so she would have to climb up to the top.
I can't quite. Oh, we're so close.
But not close enough.
Let's all stand on tiptoe.
A good idea.
So the animals tried again.
If I can just stretch a little bit further...
I think I'm going to sneeze.
Don't you dare.
Sorry.
And the animals tried again.
Only a few minutes left. I still can't reach it. What are we going to do?
Hello, everyone. Sorry I'm late. Need a hand?
Toby!
Toby knew just what to do. He climbed up Nelson's trunk, over Ronald's horn, along Zed's stripes, up Giggle's tail, until finally he was sitting on Audrey's head.
I can reach it. I can reach the juicy...
Ouch!
Oh, no!
Well caught, Toby.
Top tortoise.
Yeah!
This is the best juicy fruit ever.
What a brilliant story. I wish there was a juicy fruit tree in my garden.
Me too.
If we ever find one nearby, we'll let you know. And we'll have a juicy fruit picnic.
That would be fun.
But now, I think it's time for bed, or it'll soon be breakfast time.
64, 64, 64.
Important visitor.
Can we help you?
Good evening, Mr. Elephant. I'm the story inspector, and I've come to inspect your stories.
Stories? We have wonderful stories.
They're usually very funny.
And quite dramatic.
But they never, ever go on beyond bedtime.
Haven't I seen you somewhere before?
No, I don't think so. Now, I'd like to hear, inspect a story, please.
We'd love to tell you a story, but I'm afraid that we can't.
Why not?
We have to wait till our friend Lucy arrives.
Oh, I see.
But maybe this once we can make an exception.
Oh, thank you, Nelson.
I've got a good story for you to inspect. It's about an important visitor just like you.
Please begin.
Each morning, the animals in Africa gathered by the baobab tree to hear the latest news.
Good morning. I'm William the Weaverbird,
Welcome to the Savannah Breakfast News. First, the weather. The sun will be hot, the desert will be dry, the water will be wet, and the grass will be green. Here is a news flash. Justin, latest reports say that because the leaves have fallen early this year, Cleopatra will be visiting the waterhole today.
Who's Cleopatra?
She must be really important to be on the news.
Well, that's all for now. This was William the Weaverbird on the Savannah Breakfast News.
Hey, Esmeralda, stop it. That tickles. Have you heard the news? Cleopatra's coming this afternoon. She's really important.
Oh, dear, I've got so much dusting to do. Better get started.
Hi, Esmeralda. How's things?
Can't stop to talk, Audrey. Herbert's just told me Cleopatra's coming. I'm as tired as a Savannah. She's really very famous.
Famous? I'd better prepare some food, then.
Did someone say food?
Yes, for Cleopatra. She's a star.
Better put on a spread. Watermelon, mogo chips.
And bumbleberries. There's a bush full of ripe bumbleberries over by the jungle.
Will someone please tell me what all the fuss is about?
We're expecting a visitor.
She's really famous, so we're putting on a welcoming party and everything.
Yes, for Cleopatra.
Cleopatra? Lady Cleopatra? With a name like that, she must be a lioness.
Everyone knows that lions have royal blood. Why, our visitor must be Cleopatra, the queen of the far, far away hills.
Better do lots of mogo chips, then.
I'm taking charge immediately. Right, line up, everyone. I want a nice, tidy savannah. Try to do something about these leaves. And everyone must be on their best behavior.
So, all the animals got ready for the arrival of Cleopatra, queen of the far, far away hills.
Pick only the biggest and juiciest. Hurry up! There's no time to lose. Everything must be perfect.
Welcome, Cleopatra. Welcome, Cleopatra.
Well done, everyone. Good teamwork. Herbert, the red carpet, please. Thank you.
Well, what now, Reggie?
Now we wait for Her Royal Highness to arrive.
The animals waited and waited.
Sorry, Reginald. I didn't have much breakfast this morning.
Why don't you try one of these bumbleberries? They're very juicy.
Well, I don't know.
Go on. There's plenty. Reginald won't notice.
The bumbleberries were deliciously juicy. Nelson and Georgina ate far too many of them.
Nelson, Georgina, what are you doing? We're expecting a most important visitor. And you get the hiccups.
Hi there.
Can I help? Only we're expecting the Queen of the Far, Far Away Hills at any moment.
Hiya, I'm Cleopatra. I've come to do the leaves.
But you're not a lioness.
Course not. I'm a porcupine, silly. You must be Reggie the lion. How's it going?
But...
Reggie, the speech.
What? Oh, yes, of course. Today, we, the animals of the savannah... are gathered here to mark a very special occasion. We are here to welcome Cleopatra, the porcupine, as our honored guest. We have prepared a humble banquet of the finest food. Now, I, Reginald the Lion, would like to ask Georgina the Giraffe to perform the anthem of welcome.
Welcome, Cleopatra. Welcome, Cleopatra.
Big, 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 big.
What's he doing?
He's...
He's dancing, look.
How embarrassing. It's all gone wrong. I'm so sorry, Mom. The food, the music, it's...
Brilliant.
I beg your pardon?
Brilliant. The speech was very funny, and I really enjoyed the elephant's dance. Let's all do it again, when I've swept up the leaves.
Swept up the leaves?
Yes, that's my job. I'm a savannah sweeper. I always come and sweep up the leaves at this time of year. Oh, and you can stop calling me Cleopatra. All my friends call me Patsy. Right. What about this party, then? Excuse me, Reginald. Could I have the pleasure of the next dance?
It would be a pleasure, Cleo... Patsy.
Welcome, Cleopatra. Welcome, Cleopatra.
Everyone enjoyed the party, and they all looked forward to Patsy's next visit.
That was a lovely story, Molly.
Thank you, Mr. Story Inspector.
I give it 10 out of 10. Now, Nelson, I'd like to inspect a story from you, please.
And I give your disguise 10 out of 10, Lucy. But I'm afraid it's bedtime now.
You didn't fool us for a minute.
I thought that if I was a really important visitor, I might get an extra story.
You'll always be our most important visitor, Lucy.
Sweet dreams, everyone.
Good night, Lucy.
64, 64, 64, 64.
The story of Georgina's bumbleberry soup.
Nelson?
Hello, Lucy. Oh. I was just eating some blackberries. They're very juicy. Here, would you like one?
Thanks, Nelson. Quite nice, but I like strawberries better.
My favourite berries are gooseberries.
And ours are raspberries.
And my favourite berries are bumbleberries.
Bumbleberries?
Yes, bumbleberries are the yummiest berries in Africa. They're terrific in pies and crumbles, and they make the best soup, of course.
Georgina, are you making this up?
Oh, no, Lucy. Georgina's telling the truth. She did make bumbleberry soup once.
In that case, you better tell me the story, Molly.
One morning, Georgina the giraffe got up especially early.
It's bumbleberry day! It's bumbleberry day! It's bumbleberry day! Hey, hey, today, today, it's bumbleberry day!
Good morning, Georgina!
Hello, everyone, and happy bumbleberry day!
You sound happy, Georgina.
Yes, Toby, I am happy because today is a very special day. It's Bumbleberry Day, and I'm going to make bumbleberry soup. I'm just off to pick the bumbleberries now.
Can we come too?
I'll carry the basket.
I'll pick the bumbleberries.
And I'll eat the bumbleberries. I mean, I'll help Kevin to pick the bumbleberries.
Come on then, everyone. Follow me. Everyone ready?
Yes!
Is that enough berries for you, Georgina?
That's plenty, Toby. Now, I'm going to show you how to make bumbleberry soup from a special recipe my grandmother taught me. First, we sort the bumbleberries. Then we sieve them and star them. Mmm, I'm getting jungle with a hint of lotus flower. Ooh, delicious. Now, the soup needs to be whisked until it's pink and fluffy. But where's my whisk? I'll have to go and look for it. Doris, will you stir the soup for me?
The soup? Moi?
There, I'll be back in a minute.
Oh, it's not quite sweet enough. Fetch me some honey, Toby. Perfect. Now just a little squeeze.
Did I leave my whisk?
These curry leaves will make the soup nice and spicy.
No, it's still not right. Chuck in some bananas, Kevin. Not like that, Kevin. You're supposed to peel them first. Oh, well.
Georgina tried to reach the twig that looked like a whisk, but she couldn't stretch far enough. Meanwhile, at the jungle clearing...
Oh, do I smell food, perchance?
Georgina's making a special soup.
She's asked Doris to look after it for her.
Soup. Yummy. You'll never believe this, but I just happen to have with me the ingredient to make the finest soup in Africa.
You have?
Yes. A lovely muddy potato.
Oh, well. Right now, let's give this soup a nice big stir.
Georgina was still trying to reach the twig that looked like a whisk. But Georgina the giraffe didn't give up easily. Back in the jungle clearing, more and more animals started to arrive to find out what was cooking.
Just a little something I've been saving for that special occasion.
Georgina still couldn't reach the twig that looked like a whisk.
Has anyone got anything else?
We have.
And when the tick-tick bird put the final ingredient into the soup, it bubbled and rumbled until... Uh-oh. Georgina finally...
to grab the twig.
Hello, everyone. Have you come to try my special soup?
Hi, Georgina. I think the soup's all right. I just stirred it, just like you said.
My soup! My beautiful bumbleberry soup! What have you done to it?
We've added a few things, you see.
We wanted to make the soup even better.
But bumbleberry soup is made with bumbleberries only, nothing else. It's a special recipe. It's ruined, and I've just used up all the bumbleberries. Oh!
I know. Why don't we make Georgina a special treat?
Doris thought of a plan to cheer Georgina up.
We've come to say sorry about the soup. We thought you might like these.
Mogo chips. We cooked them ourselves.
Oh, that's so kind of you all. Thanks. I'll just try one. Ooh, that's quite nice. I'll try another one if I may. Delicious.
That was a funny story, Molly.
Funny and yummy, too. What? What are you all looking at me for?
Nothing, Nelson. Good night.
Good night, Lucy.
Sweet dreams.
Story of Herbert's birthday party.
Hi, everybody!
Hi, Lucy!
Well, aren't you all excited? Don't you know that something special's going to happen?
Like what?
Well, like a party or something.
What sort of a party?
Well, how about a birthday party? You know, with balloons and presents.
That would be great fun.
But to have a birthday party...
It has to be someone's birthday.
Exactly.
It's a pity we don't know anyone whose birthday it is, isn't it?
Well... Actually...
Yes?
Well, actually, it's my birthday today.
Oh!
Is it really? It had completely slipped my mind. And they say an elephant never forgets.
How foolish of us to forget.
So, there's no party then?
No, not today. Sorry.
Never mind. You'll have another birthday next year.
Yes, I suppose I will.
Surprise!
Oh, thanks!
Now then, how about a special birthday story?
I know. I'll tell you the one about Herbert's party.
Oh, yes!
Herbert was a very busy warthog. Every morning he would get up, have a bath, dry himself down, then he'd make some breakfast. And go for a long walk with his best friends, the flies.
Now, Herbert would be the first to admit that he wasn't the tidiest of animals. In fact, his appearance was a bit of a joke on the savannah, but everyone loved him.
Morning, Herbert. Nice day for the flies.
Hello, Herbert. Grown any nice warts lately? One day, Herbert was wallowing in the mud when he heard excited voices making plans for a party.
It's going to be great fun. Lots of music and dancing.
Keep still!
Your new stripes look great!
Quiet, it's a secret. We don't want old Dusty Bottom to find out.
I can't wait!
Hi, girls. Gosh, you look great.
Oh, hi, Herbert. Would you mind standing downwind?
Sorry?
The smell. The flies.
Oh, yes. I'm sorry. Of course. Clear off, you lot. Go on, buzz off. You're both looking very glamorous today. Going somewhere nice?
Do you think this pink really suits me?
Can I come?
Do I look too big in these eyelashes?
Well, can I?
Oh, sorry, Herbert. We can't gossip all day. We've got things to do.
Oh, yes. Right, of course.
Herbert wondered why everyone was ignoring him.
They're going to a party and I'm not invited. I suppose I do look a bit of a mess. Time for a warthog makeover.
Herbert had a long, luxurious pink bath.
Pink mud for the best-smelling warthog at the party.
Then he went for a haircut.
La 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 la.
Oh, Herbert, keep still.
La 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 la. Ouch!
Oops, so sorry.
La 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 la.
Nearly there. What about that?
Wow, groovy.
The other animals were getting ready for the party too.
No sign of Herbert. Let's start the party preparations without him.
Anybody there? Nelson? Zed? Molly? They're not here. Music? And it's coming from my place.
Pizza, 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 pizza.
La 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 la.
Hey, it's my birthday today. It's my party. So that's what all the fuss was about. Surprise, surprise. Hey, guys, let's party.
Who are you?
Why, I'm Herbert, of course.
Oh?
You're not Herbert.
Oh, yes, I am.
Oh, no, you're not!
Herbert's smelly and dusty.
And itchy and funny and friendly.
You're much too smart and quite grumpy.
Where's Herbert?
What have you done with him?
Oh, dear me.
Get him!
Wait, stop! I am Herbert. Look. Nelson, old pal, old buddy. Oh. Let me have it.
you do look a bit like Herbert, but I'm still not sure.
What about this?
There's still something missing.
I know!
It is Herbert!
We didn't think it was you. You know, without the smell and the dust.
And the flies.
Will you forgive us, Herbert?
Well, okay.
Hooray!
Wait. On one condition.
Yes?
Yes?
We'll do anything at all.
I forgive you if you...
Yes!
If you all have a mud bath.
A mud bath?
It's my birthday. I'm a warthog, so you've got to do things the warthog way.
Herbert had the best party ever.
La 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 la.
Wicked! A big mud bath and dust and flies! What a great idea for a party!
Good night, birthday girl.
Good night, Nelson.
Sweet dreams!
Story of the Jungle Pie.
Good evening, Nelson.
Oh, hello, Lucy.
What are you doing?
Friday is cabbage day at the zoo, and cabbages are my favourite food. Oh, yum. A red one, delicious. Here, try one.
Ah, no, not for me, thanks. Cabbage tastes yuck.
Yuck! Yuck! How can you say that?
Have you ever tried eating cabbage, Lucy?
Well, no, I haven't. But it looks so... cabbagey.
Perhaps I should tell you a special story.
It's not a story about cabbages, I hope.
Oh, no, no. Not cabbages. This is a story about a jungle pie. Kevin the crocodile, Doris the duck, and Toby the tortoise were having a picnic in the jungle.
Mogo chips.
And tweak burgers.
I wouldn't eat anything else.
Yoo-hoo! Would you like some fruit for dessert?
Oh, yes, please, Georgina. Oh, a yum-yum fruit.
I'll have some grapes.
What would you like, Kevin?
Nothing, thanks. I don't eat fruit.
What? You don't eat fruit?
No.
But it's fun to try new foods.
No. Eating twig burgers and mogo chips is more fun.
Oh, what a shame. Oh. I wished I could convince Kevin to try different foods. I needed a plan and some helpers. Listen, everybody. That's all agreed, then.
Yes!
Natalie, let's put the plan into action.
Righto, Nelson.
No, Toby. This is how you play duck in the water.
Like this?
Not bad for a tortoise.
Look at me, Doris.
Hello, everyone. I've got exciting news. Georgina wants us to bake a jungle pie. It's going to be the yummiest thing ever. Can you come and help?
Of course!
Not me. I only eat twig burgers and mogo chips.
Well...
That's fine, Kevin. We'll cook a twig burger just for you. All that we ask is that you help us prepare the jungle pie. A deal?
Deal.
First, Kevin helps Nelson grow vegetables for the jungle pie.
Kevin, do be careful, please.
Sorry.
Here, I'll show you how to harvest carrots. You have to do it slowly so the carrots don't snap. That's it. Everything okay, Kevin?
Mm-hmm.
Hurry up, Kevin. Don't forget you have to help Herbert as well.
Kevin was surprised to find the carrot tasted sweet.
No jungle pie is complete without some yummy worms. Now, let me show you how to catch worms the warthog way. Your turn, Kevin. You'll get used to the taste.
No, I won't.
But secretly, Kevin quite liked the worm. It tasted a bit like a mogo chip, only squishier. It was time to collect bumbleberries.
Ready, everyone?
Yes!
Here goes! And remember, no snacking.
Kevin wanted to try a bumbleberry too. It was juicy and yummy. Herbert, do we have to have worms?
Of course, they're the best bit.
Oh, wonderful bumbleberries. Have you two been snacking?
Oh, no, Georgina, no, we'd never do that.
And here are the carrots.
Oh, thank you, Nelson. Kevin, would you like to stir the mixture?
Oh, yes, please.
That's it. Stir it gently and don't let anyone snack. While you stir, I will take care of the oven. Kevin decided to have a little taste. So, Kevin, how's it going? Well done, Kevin. Come on, everyone. Time to bake this pie. Finally, the pie was baking in the oven. Then I remembered my promise to Kevin. I'll be back soon. The animals waited.
I think it's ready.
Careful, Nelson. It will be hot.
Here, use this.
Oh, thank you, Doris. Stand back, everyone. Wait a minute, Herbert. The pie is steaming hot. The best
ever without a doubt.
Yoo-hoo! I'm back! And this is for you, Kevin. Oh, what's the matter, Kevin?
Oh, nothing. It's just I'm not that hungry.
Here, Kevin, try some jungle pie instead.
Okay.
Well?
It's delicious!
And that's how Kevin the crocodile learnt to eat new things.
It's fun to taste new things.
That's right.
Nelson, I think I would like to taste some of the cabbage.
Oh!
Thank you.
Well?
I like it!
Hooray!
And now it's time for bed.
Good night, everyone.
Good night, Lucy.
Sweet dreams!
Joy's sleepover.
Whee! Hi, Lucy!
Hello, everyone. Guess what? Tomorrow night, I'm going on a sleepover.
A sleepover?
What's that?
I'll stay at my cousin Max's house and sleep on a mattress on the floor in his bedroom.
Oh, how exciting.
Sounds like you'll have lots of fun.
Yes, that's what Max said. But I'm not so sure.
Why not, Lucy?
Well, how will I go to sleep without a kiss from my mum?
Don't worry, Lucy. Things may be a little different in Max's house.
But it's bound to be heaps of fun.
Stop bouncing, Ribbit. Have you got a story for me?
You better have. Every evening as the sun set behind the great red rock, Joey the kangaroo went to sleep in his mum's pouch.
Oh, Mum!
You've been bouncing around all day. You must be tired.
No, I'm not.
Night, sweetie.
Night, Mum.
Joey loved sleeping inside his mum's pouch. It was snug and dark and cosy. The next day was special. It was Joey's mum's birthday.
Ready, son?
I'd completely forgotten it was my birthday.
Yes, but we didn't forget.
Thank you, thank you.
Hey, the ants, they're stealing Mum's breakfast.
Don't worry, son. We'll make Mum another brekkie. Oh, and before I forget...
Two tickets for Wally the Wombat's didgeridoo concert tonight. Oh!
What about Joey? We can't just leave him here.
Can't he sleep in your pouch?
The music'll be too noisy.
Joey!
Phoebe!
Hi, Joey. Ready to play?
Huh? What's that?
Yeah, let's do some face painting.
Mama'll like that. It's her birthday today.
Oh, what presents did she get?
Well, she's supposed to be going to a concert tonight, but she can't because she has to stay home and look after me.
Hey, why don't you come to my home for a sleepover? That way your mum can go to the concert.
Yeah, okay, but we'll have to check with our mums.
The two mums agreed it was a great idea.
Yay!
In the evening, Joey's mum and dad drop Joey off at Phoebe's home.
What if he doesn't settle?
Oh, this is gonna be bonza.
I'm sure Joey will be just fine, Janet.
Let's play boomerangs.
Bye, son.
Bye, Mum.
While Joey and Phoebe played, Koala Mama cooked dinner. She was making eucalyptus soup, an old koala recipe.
Kids, dinner's ready. Don't forget to wash your ears before dinner.
Don't you mean paws?
Koala bears always wash their ears before dinner.
Why don't you wash your ears and your paws?
Yeah. Oh, I've never had eucalyptus soup before.
It's delicious.
Yum.
Time for bed, kids. Race you to the top.
You sleep up there?
Yes, of course. Come on up.
Oh, kangaroos aren't very good at climbing trees.
Don't worry. At least it saves me collecting them for breakfast.
Mum, Joey and I could sleep in hammocks tonight.
Hammocks? What are those?
You'll see.
This is a great show, but I do hope little Joey's all right. He's never been away from home before.
He'll be fine. I bet he's fast asleep by now.
Bonza.
Yeah, you're my best mate.
And you're my best mate. I like the eucalyptus soup.
So did I.
It's getting late, kids. Remember, this is a sleepover, so time for sleep. Night, night.
Night, Mum. Night, Joey.
Now everyone else was asleep. Joey felt a little bit lonely. But then he looked up at the sky.
Wow! All those stars. The Great Red Rock. Wally's didgeridoo. Mum Kangaroo.
Joey's mum and dad had had a fabulous time at the concert, but it was late and time to go home.
Thank you, darling. I had a wonderful birthday.
Since we're passing by, I think we should just make sure Joey's okay.
Good night, sweetie.
The next morning, Joey and Phoebe were up early.
Mum, guess what? Mum.
Oh, hello, sweetie.
Mum, I had a great time at Phoebe's. We washed our hands and then our ears as well, because that's what koala bears do. And then we had soup and it was made from eucalyptus leaves and it was yummy.
Joey, I'm glad you had such a great time. Next time, perhaps Phoebe can come here for a sleepover.
Yay! Oh, thanks, Mum.
I've never been on a sleepover before. Where would I sleep?
Well, we've got a sort of mobile bedroom. It's called a pouch. Want to try it?
All aboard for the Kangaroo Express!
Oh, it's really comfy.
And so Joey and Phoebe set off on a bouncy ride through the outback. It was the best fun they'd ever had.
Boing! Boing! Sleepovers do sound like a lot of fun. There's only one problem.
What's that?
If I go on a sleepover to Max's house, I'll miss my bedtime story.
I have an idea. Why don't you tell Max a bedtime story?
A sleepover story from Australia.
Bonza!
Good night, Lucy.
Good night, everyone.
Sweet dreams!
Georgina, Queen of Fashion.
Hello, Lucy. My, my, you do look glum today.
It's these pyjamas.
But we love your pyjamas.
You look very nice in them.
Well, I don't want to wear them.
Why not? Are they too tight?
No.
Are they too loose?
No, they're unfashionable.
Unfashionable?
My friend Yasmin wears pink pyjamas. And Robin wears purple ones with yellow flowers, so I don't want to wear these old blue pyjamas anymore.
But they suit you.
Nobody else wears blue pyjamas.
Sometimes it's good to be fashionable, and sometimes it's good to be yourself.
Good to be yourself?
Georgina should know. She was the fashion queen of Africa.
She was? Oh, please tell me about it.
Every morning, Georgina the giraffe woke up especially early to enjoy a big breakfast of juicy leaves.
Yum, 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 going to fill my tum with yummy, yum leaves today. I need to eat a lot, cause my neck's so long and my tum is so far away. Oh. Morning, Herbert.
Morning, Georgina.
Would you like some leaves?
No, yuck, no, not for me. I'm having some nice slimy worms and a yummy lump of mud for my breakfast. And a muddy potato. And, oh, well, I must say your new hat suits you.
What hat?
Quite the fashion, I would say.
Fashion? Oh, yes, I suppose so.
Oh. Well, I must be on my way. Lots of slimy worms to swallow.
I do look fashionable.
Wow.
I don't know how you do it.
Do what?
You know, look so fabulous all the time.
Oh, you mean my hat? Oh, yes, everyone will be wearing one soon. Herbert says hats are, fashionable.
Fashionable?
Later that morning, when the animals gathered for a drink at the waterhole...
Yoo-hoo!
It's Georgina. Wow, she looks fabulous.
Don't you just love my hat?
It's so you.
I must have one.
I am Georgina, Queen of Fashion.
Soon, every animal on the savannah was making a hat.
A swirl!
Hello, everyone.
on. Gather round, gather round. Nelson, we're waiting. Now, here's right in between. Everyone who is anyone seems to be wearing a hat nowadays, so we're going to stage a fashion show tonight. Yay! I am going to be wearing the most bestest hat in all of Africa.
All the animals and birds were very busy. Even Nelson made a special hat.
Do my ears look big in this?
Oh no, you look very fashionable.
Yay!
Hello, everyone, and welcome to tonight's fashion extravaganza.
Oh, yes.
And our first model is Nelson the elephant in a fantastic little number. A hard hat featuring Toby the tortoise and Doris the duck with her yellow feathers. Yay! And now Zed in his banana bandana. And here's Natalie.
The hats were uncomfortable and looked rather silly, but none of the animals dared say anything.
And now it's Molly the hippo in a colourful crown. I need just one more piece of fruit for my bestest hat. Aha! I can't reach. In her feather hat. Excuse me, but you're standing on my hat.
Sorry, Nat.
Oh!
Hey, watch out!
Ouch!
Oh!
Oh dear! Someone's going to get hurt. Do you like my hat?
Like it? Why, it was delicious.
It's my bestest hat. My reputation eaten by a warthog. What have you done, Herbert? What have you done?
Well, don't worry. It was much too big anyway.
Too big.
Don't worry, I've got an idea. Listen, what we do is the
And now, the lady you've all been waiting for, Georgina, Queen of Fashion.
Oh. No hat.
It's the new fashion.
She's wearing earrings.
They are so chic. And, better still, very comfortable. It's good to be fashionable now and then, but it's much better to be yourself. I've written a song about it.
Oh, can we join in?
Of course. Fashion is fine, but you can't wear it all the time. It's good to be yourself. When things go wrong, just sing this little song. It's good to be yourself. Hip hooray, hip hip hooray, it's good to be yourself. Fashion is fine, but you can't wear it all the time.
So it's good to be yourself.
And that's how Georgina became Fashion Queen of Africa.
So, Lucy, are you in fashion?
Oh, no.
Fashion changes so quickly, I just don't know.
A little bird told me that blue pyjamas will be in fashion tomorrow.
They will?
Yasmin's mum bought some blue pyjamas today.
She did?
Because Yasmin thinks you're fashionable.
Brilliant!
Something else is in fashion now.
What's that?
Sleep. Everyone is tired and ready for bed.
Sweet dreams, everyone.
Sweet dreams, you see.
64, 64, 64.
Story of Pauline the Pelican.
Bracelet.
Oh, that's very pretty. Whose name is that?
It says E-M-M-A. Emma. Was it a present from Emma?
No. Not really. I borrowed it from her.
You mean you asked Emma if you could wear her bracelet for a while?
Not exactly.
This reminds me of the story of Pauline the Pelican. Would you like to hear it?
Well...
Oh, yes. I think you should.
All right. I do love your stories, Molly.
Every day, just as the sun was climbing in the sky, Pauline the Pelican would go fishing for her breakfast on Water Lily Lake. One day, the fish were particularly clever and slippery. No matter how hard she tried, Pauline couldn't catch a thing.
Yummy, scrummy fish in view!
Seamus the stork wasn't having any trouble finding fish. He caught lots of fish that day already.
One for me, and one for me. And another one for me. And one for Seamus, of course.
Seamus had caught so many fish, he couldn't carry them all back to his nest.
Oh, well, I suppose I can leave this one behind and come back for it later. Ready for takeoff? Let's go!
Seamus had left behind a very big and tasty fish, and Pauline was feeling hungry.
Oh, that's me tummy rumbling. Seamus doesn't need this fish. I'll take it and catch another one for him later. I'm sure he won't mind. Anyway, I'll never know.
What a cheek!
Herbert the Warthog was feeling happy. He'd just had a dust bath and found a huge watermelon.
My watermelon! Where's it gone? Where's it gone? Oh, what a nasty shock that was. Naughty watermelon, hiding from Herbert like that. Safe at last. Time for a little trot before lunchtime, Herbert? Why not? Then we can gobble it down. Watermelon. Watermelon.
Pauline thought the watermelon looked delicious.
Oh, my watermelon. Where's it gone?
As Pauline flew over the savannah, she spotted Reginald the lion dozing in the long grass.
Snooze.
my lovely, tasty bone. Mmm.
Reginald is fast asleep. I'm sure he won't mind if I eat that bone now and bring him another one later.
Mm-hmm. Lovely bone. Just for Reggie.
Pauline's beak was so full of food she couldn't fly. She had to walk the rest of the way back home.
Hello? Anyone at home? Good evening, Pauline.
We're not disturbing your tea or anything.
Actually, we've come to warn you.
Yes, it seems someone woofed my watermelon. I'd buried it in the safest place in the whole savannah. Now there's not a sign of it anywhere. It's just not fair.
Someone has been taking food without asking. I lost a bone.
And A lost a fish.
And I lost the juiciest watermelon in the whole world.
So be on your guard, Pauline Pelican, and don't leave any food lying around.
Or you may be next.
Even hiding it in holes doesn't help.
Well, we'll leave you to get on with whatever you were doing. Just thought we'd better warn you.
Bye.
Pauline felt very guilty and wished she'd never taken the food. Even though she was so hungry that her tummy was rumbling, she decided to give the food back to her friends.
This will be difficult. If Reginald catches me with his bone, I'm in big trouble. Oh, well, here goes.
It was very dark when Pauline finally got home. She hadn't eaten anything all day, but she was happy that all the food was back where it belonged, and she fell into a deep sleep.
Wakey, wakey, Pauline!
What's happening? Is it someone's birthday?
No.
And it's not Christmas?
No, it's not.
So?
We decided we'd got so much food that we'd share it. We're going to have a party. The cake is a present for you because you're our favourite pelican.
Oh, I don't know what to say.
How about let's eat?
Yeah, let's go down to the lake and eat our cake.
Fishes and cream! Oh! Yay!
Pauline was very happy.
And Seamus and Reggie and Herbert were happy too.
And they all had lots to eat. I think I'll give Emma her bracelet back tomorrow.
Good idea.
And I'm going to make her a cake, like they did for Pauline.
With fishes and cream?
Yuck! I don't think so. I want her to stay my friend.
It's much too late for baking cakes now. Time for bed, I think.
Thanks for the story. Good night.
Good night, Lucy.
Story on.
off to Puffin's treasure.
I've never been to the sea.
Neither have we. We should have a story about the seashore.
That's a great idea. Does anyone know one?
No, we don't.
No, sorry.
Oh, dear. So no one knows the story about the seashore?
I do. My name is Connor, and I've lived by the sea all of my life. Now, is everybody ready for my story?
Yes!
One morning on Mossy Bay, the puffins were playing football. Over here, Sharon. Fetch it.
Don't be foolish. The sea is too rough, and you are just a young puffin, not strong enough to fly out there. But do not worry, my puffin friends. If you are patient, then the ball will return.
Silly Mr. Mustache, how can the ball come back on its own?
It will return. Be patient. The young ones. So much to learn. Now, where was I? My thank you letter to Auntie. She loves poetry, but I'm no poet. Dear Aunt Louise, the weather here, it freezes. No. Why is it so hard to find the rhyme?
The next morning, the puffins woke up early and hurried down to the beach to look for their board.
Nothing here.
Nothing in the rock pool.
A seashell. Oh, it's really pretty.
Who left Sharon the presents?
She must have a secret admirer.
I wish they'd left her a ball instead.
Next day, there was still no sign of the puffin's ball.
Nothing.
Hey, look, another present. We can make a seesaw.
This time, it was Jamie who had been left a present.
Leaving us this treasure on the beach?
We have to find out.
I know. Let's ask Gunner. He sees everything from up there.
Hey, Gunner! Someone keeps leaving us treasure on the beach and we want to know who.
Can you help us, please?
I flew up to take a look, but there was no one to be seen across Mossy Bay. And not a single footprint in the sand. It was a mystery.
Hey, it's raining.
No, it's not. Look, it's them and the whale.
The puffins asked Thelma if she knew anyone who might leave treasure on the beach.
Oh, no, my dears, but I will keep my eyes open for you.
Thelma sailed right around the island, but she didn't see anyone. There was no one left to ask except...
Hercule Moustache! He knows everything!
Yeah, but I won't be asking him.
Nor me.
He's far too grumpy.
So why don't we play a game to decide who asks?
Okay!
We each pick a piece of seaweed. The one who picks the shortest piece has to go and ask Mr. Moustache.
Hercule Moustache was still trying to write a poem.
Thank you, Auntie, for the lovely muffin. It was as light as a... I will never think of a word to rhyme with muffin.
Mr. Moustache?
Aha! Puffin! The muffin as light as a puffin! Come closer, little puffin. How may I help you?
Jamie told Hercule all about the treasure on the beach.
I know exactly how we can solve this mystery of yours, my little friend. It's a clear night. You will surely see who leaves the treasure on the beach, but you must stay awake.
I know. Let's sing a song.
We go puffin' here, we go puffin' there. Here a puffin', there a puffin', everywhere a puff-puff-puffin'.
Sing along, Mr. Moustache.
Puffin' do, puffin' do. Give me the moonlight, give me the fish. The little ones are too tired to stay awake.
It is time
to see who brings the treasure to Mossy Bay.
But there's nobody there.
Our football? That's our football?
Yay!
But I don't understand. How has it come back?
The tide has brought your football back. And all the other treasures.
What is the tide, Mr. Moustache?
The sea and her mysterious ways. Every day, the tide comes in, and every day, the tide goes out. Sometimes, the waves collect things from the beach.
Oh, like our ball.
May we? And sometimes, they leave things behind.
Like the seashell and the piece of wood.
Exactly.
Let's play.
I said your ball would come back if you were... Oh! Patient. See you later, little friends.
And that, landlubbers, is the end of my seashore story.
Thank you very much, Gunnar. That was lovely.
I wish we lived by the beach.
Yes! We could all go exploring for treasure.
Ah, but you're lucky. You've got the best treasure of all.
What's that?
I know. We're lucky because we have lots and lots of stories.
Exactly, Molly.
But it's too late for any more stories tonight, Lucy.
Good night, everyone.
Good night, Lucy.
64, 64, 64.
Bad Teeth Day.
Whee!
Lucy, what have you got there?
This? Oh, it's a sticker. The dentist gave it to me.
What's a dentist?
It's a bit like a doctor, I suppose. Except a dentist looks after your teeth.
May we have a sticker too, Lucy?
You only get a sticker if you brush your teeth properly. I brush my teeth every morning and every evening. Now, let me see. Did you all brush your teeth today? Boris?
I forgot.
That's not very good.
Lucy is right, you know. It's important to look after your teeth. Do you remember when Victor the Crocodile had trouble with his teeth?
Of course I do. Victor's Bad Teeth Day.
Victor's Bad Teeth Day? Tell us the whole story, Molly.
Every morning in Africa, Kevin the Crocodile and his friends Doris and Toby met at the Zambam River.
Scrub and brush, do not brush, smile away, crocodile.
Hey, there's something in the water.
Oh, it's only Victor.
Have you come to brush your teeth too, Victor?
Crocodiles don't brush their teeth.
But I brush my teeth, and I'm a crocodile.
Kevin, everyone knows you're not a proper crocodile.
But Victor, if you don't brush your teeth, they will get dirtier and dirtier.
Well, can't stay to chat. I have a busy day ahead. So many butterflies to bully. Bye.
Oh, never mind him. Let's play a game. How about hide and seek?
I'll do the counting. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
Victor decided to frighten some tadpoles first.
Snap! Snap!
Victor, do you like my flower? Zed the zebra has asked me out to a dance. I'm so excited.
Very nice, Natalie.
Have you girls seen any dragonflies around?
You're not going to do anything nasty, are you?
Nasty? Me? I don't know the meaning of the word.
Oh, what's that stuck between your teeth, Victor?
Oh, nothing. Must go.
Bye.
Then he went looking for dragonflies.
Snap!
Oh. Oh, hi there, Victor. Who's the coolest zebra around? It's me, Zed the Zebra. It's so important to keep well groomed, wouldn't you agree? Clipping hooves, polishing stripes, and brushing teeth, of course. That sort of thing. You're very quiet. Are you feeling all right? Well, I'd better go and practice my dance moves.
Victor was starting to worry. His teeth were getting dirtier and dirtier. Meanwhile, in the jungle...
Would you like some bananas, Tickles?
Yes, please, Giggles.
Catch. Catch. Brilliant.
Coconut, Giggles.
Yes, please. Hey!
Snap! Snap! Snap!
Victor was wondering who to frighten next. Then he saw some fish leaping in and out of the Zambam Falls.
This is such a fun game! Snap! 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 What's all this stuff?
Oops!
Oh my, oh my! What a mess! Are you all right, Victor?
No, it's not there.
And tickles. How many times have I told you not to throw rubbish in the river? As for you, Victor, serves you right.
Don't say that, Doris. Victor needs our help.
Okay. Here. A toothbrush for you, Victor.
But Doris, this is too big a job for a toothbrush.
I suppose you're right.
What shall we do then?
Giggles and Tickles had an idea.
Leave it to us, clever monkeys with clever fingers. Okay, we'll take Victor for a walk while you get busy.
Giggles and Tickles set to work. Meanwhile, Doris, Kevin and Toby played a game of Snap with Victor.
Snap!
Your turn, Toby. Snap! You're supposed to say Snap, Victor. Everybody ready for the grand surprise? Follow us! Ready, Tickles!
Ready!
Rub and brush, do not rush. Smile a while, crocodile.
Ow.
What? What's up?
You're supposed to say thank you, Victor.
Do I have to?
Yes, you do. Victor?
Thank you.
That's how Victor learned to brush his teeth and to say thank you.
What a brilliant story, Molly. Well done.
Do we deserve a sticker now, Lucy?
Oh, I'm sorry, Boris. I don't have any extra stickers. I have an idea. Would you like a kiss instead?
Yes!
Good night, Georgina. Good night, Nelson. Good night, Molly. Good night, Giggles. And Tickles. Good night, Boris.
Good night, Lucy.
Petula the Parrot.
Hello, Lucy.
It looks like somebody has lost her voice. Don't worry, Lucy. We'll help you find it. Won't we, everybody?
Yes!
It's not here.
Or here.
Oh, dear. I hope I haven't stepped on it.
everybody. We found Lucy's voice.
It's over here.
Oh? Are you sure it's Lucy's voice you found, Tickles?
Yes, here I am, Nelson.
How did you do that, Lucy?
She didn't.
I did.
How was that, fellas?
That was perfect, Petula. Perfect.
That was very funny, Giggles. But you and Tickles weren't laughing when Petula played a trick on you. Now, were you?
Oh, but that was different.
Yeah, completely different.
Why? What happened? Nelson?
Ah, I think Giggles and Tickles should tell us all the story, don't you, Lucy?
One day, Tickles and I were looking for something to eat in the jungle.
But we couldn't find a piece of fruit anywhere.
Now, let's see. Grapes, oranges, bananas, yum yum fruit. What else do I need for the party? Ah, yes, sticky berries.
I think we've hit the jackpot, Giggles. Look!
Wow, I've never seen so much fruit.
Well, what are we waiting for? Let's dive in. Wahoo!
Hey, don't eat them all. Leave some for me. After a really big fruit fight and stuffing ourselves silly, we were both feeling very tired. I'm pooped.
Yeah, me too. Oh, my hands are all sticky. I'll have to go to the river to wash them.
Petula the parrot had returned to her tree and she wasn't happy. All my lovely fruit is gone. Now I don't have anything to give my friends at the party. I'll teach those monkeys a lesson. It was now that Petula started to play her tricks.
Help! Somebody help me!
Ooh, Tickles, is that you?
Of course it is, silly. Hurry up, I'm stuck.
Stuck? Stuck where? I can't see you.
Down here, in the snake hole.
Tickles, can you hear me? Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you, Giggles.
Don't worry, Tickles. I'll have you out of there in no time.
That's what he thinks.
Is all the fruit juice washed off, Tickles?
Yes, Kevin. You can stop splashing now.
Tickles, over here, quick, Tickles.
Hey, did you hear that, Tickles?
It's Giggles.
It sounds like he's in trouble.
He's eaten too many bananas, that's all. Oh, I'll go and have a look just in case.
Bye-bye, Tickles.
Giggles? Where are you, Giggles?
Up here, Tickles. Hurry!
What are you doing up there?
I'm tangled up in the branches. You have to shake the tree to help get me loose.
Shake the tree? But it's so big.
Tickles, faster! Faster, Tickles, faster!
That'll teach him to spoil my party. Oh! Oh, oh!
Help! I'm stuck! Somebody help!
Don't worry. I'll help you.
Nelson.
What were you doing with your head down a snake hole, Giggles?
I was trying to reach Tickles.
You mean Tickles is stuck down there too?
Yes, I think he must have fallen asleep because he hadn't said a word for ages.
Well, we'd better wake him up, hadn't we? I can't blow any more, Giggles. There's only one thing for it. You'll just have to dig Tickles out. Ah, Tickles! I see you managed to get out of that hole you were in.
Hole? What hole?
Giggles will be happy.
He'll be even more happy when I get him down from this tree.
Oh, Giggles is up in this tree? Strange. Maybe I can help you. Oops! Uh-oh. Whoops. That was close.
Eddie, there you are. Now, what did Auntie Molly tell you about climbing trees?
One last shake, Tickles. Uh-oh.
Oh, no! Hold on tight, Giggles!
Oopsie-daisy. Sorry, Tickles.
Tickles, can you hear me?
Giggles, can you hear me?
Yes, yes, Tickles, where are you?
Ah! Giggles!
Tickles!
I saved you!
Huh?
Come on, Giggles and Tickles, you're welcome to join in our party. After all, you both earned it. Look, there's enough food for everyone.
Yeah! And so we stuffed ourselves silly again.
That was a very nice story, Tickles.
Hey, Lucy! Your voice is back!
Oh, yes, it is. Now I can tell you all a story.
I don't think so, Lucy. It's bedtime now.
Oh, Petula.
Good night, Lucy.
Good night, everyone.
Sweet dreams.